The Tale of Attacus, the Water Dancing Rat. A story by Richard Colvin with illustrations by Sally Cheng. Chapter 4. The Lesson. For the first few days of training, Attacus and Barkforth settled into a routine. Barkforth watched Attacus dance, offered advice, suggested changes, and then they would drill and drill the more complex moves over and over till Attacus's body was aching and exhausted, and only his will to move kept him working. Attacus had never been happier, and he soaked up everything Barkforth had to say. It was everything he dreamed. Then, one day, Attacus exited the water, and Barkforth, with a puzzled expression, said, "Tell me, Attacus, why do you dance like a swan?" Attacus wasn't aware he danced like anything. "I used to hide in the rushes and watch you teach," Attacus admitted. "Attacus, what I mean is, however hard you try, you will never be a swan. You're a rat." Sensing Atticus's pending anxiety, Barkforth added, "You are smaller, leaner, quicker. In the days when all the animals competed in the dance, mustn't the other animals have had their own style?" Attacus had never considered this. "I don't know how a rat water dances," Barkforth added, "but I do know it's probably not like a swan." They both sat on the riverbank, looked across the water and pondered. "Before I decided to watch you teach, I used to just make up my own dances and..." Attacus hesitated. "And?" Barkforth asked. "Well, I used to love to make a splash and then dive through it." Barkforth's feathers bristled and she closed her eyes for a second. "Splashing," Barkforth shuddered. A lifetime dedicated to the perfect grace had made her disapproval not easily stifled, but then she composed herself and said, "Show me." Attacus swam to the centre of the river, beat the river with his hind paws, then, when the spray was at its highest, dived quickly to the bottom, pushed himself off the riverbed up through the falling spray. He then performed a double spin and dived back under with not so much as a hint of a splash. Barkforth watched the little rat swim towards her. "It's certainly something a swan would never do," Barkforth thought. Then Attacus returned with an expectant gaze. "Hmm," said Barkforth, if only to fill the gap till her brain found something to say. "You finished the double spin so early, it's quite remarkable. As for the splashing, it's something every swan would be marked down for," said Barkforth. "I find the spins very easy. Could you do a triple?" asked Barkforth. "Oh yes," said Attacus confidently. "More?" asked Barkforth. "I never tried," Attacus admitted. 3 hours later, and exhausted, Attacus listened to a very excited Barkforth. "With a great deal of work, I'm sure you could get up to 5 spins. You'd probably be the only animal ever to attempt such a thing, certainly the only one in living memory. And while swimming your perfect circles, one of the 5 maneuvers every dance must contain, you could rotate your body while you swim. That's something no swan could even attempt. And what's more," Attacus listened intently to Barkforth's ideas for the dance, excitement building in his little chest. "I'm going to win," he thought. The next morning, while exploring the training grounds, Attacus bumped into Shay and each gave the other a deep, affectionate bow. "I heard you whoop for me when my name was announced," Shay said. "Your advice helped a great deal, Attacus." "If you hadn't stuck up for me at the riverbank, I wouldn't be here at all," said Attacus. They walked and talked about their routines. Shay felt her strongest point was her line, and she excitedly and openly talked about her finding poise and grace in her dance. Attacus talked about Barkforth and them trying to discover how a rat dances, how they'd spent a day working through an idea only to rule it out. "Like what?" asked Shay. "Like splashing," answered Attacus. Shay stopped in her tracks and looked stunned at Attacus. "You spent all day working on splashing?" "Yeah," said Attacus. "Cool," said Shay, and the two carried on walking and talking. When they reached the corner of the grounds, Shay stopped again and turned to Attacus. "Want to see something?" Shay said in an excited tone. "Sure," said Attacus, and Shay led the two under a shrubbery to a secluded part of the river, and there, on the river, was the most beautiful swan Attacus had ever seen. "His name's Silverbrook," whispered Shay wondrously. "They say when he hatched, he fell into the river and just swam. And since that day, all he has done is swim and train." Attacus watched the water part for Silverbrook and saw for the first time another animal disappear into the dance. He glided through the water and soared into the sky, and as he came down to land, his broad, majestic wings opened and stopped him just above the water's surface. Then, with a push of his wings, he performed a mid-air backflip, landing in the water like it also knew it was part of something special. He glided through the water and soared into the sky, and as he came to land, his broad, majestic wings opened and stopped him just above the water's surface. Then, with a push of his wings, he performed a mid-air backflip, landing in the water like it also knew it was part of something exceptional, and so made way for the swan. As he danced, even the tussling of the leaves in the wind became like music. Attacus and Shay watched in amazed silence until a knot started forming in Atticus's chest, and he came to a realization. He would not be able to beat Silverbrook. "They say he'll even rival Barkforth," Shay said. Attacus jumped back. "I need to go," he whispered. I'm late for training," and with that, he scampered back to his patch. "I can't win, I can't win, I can't win. What do I do? I can't win,"